Welcome to PipingStress.net, the only YouTube channel solely dedicated to piping design, piping stress, and pipe supporting systems, with animated videos to support learning. This is a video on air-cooled heat exchangers. Maintaining optimal temperatures is crucial in industrial operations. What would happen if water is not easily accessible or if environmental regulations restrict its usage? Air coolers are an innovative solution that utilizes the power of ambient air to provide cooling. Join us as we unravel the intricacies of air cooler parts, explore the imperative need for their utilization, delve into the nuances of piping design, and conduct stress analysis on their connections. Let's get started. Air cooler units differ from other heat exchangers in that they use circulated air instead of liquid as the cooling agent. These units typically consist of fin tube bundles with a header box attached to each end, which are supported horizontally by a steel frame or structure. In a single-pass arrangement, the inlet nozzles are situated at the top of the header box, while the outlet nozzles are located at the opposite end and mounted on the bottom of the header box. On the other hand, in a double-pass arrangement, the outlet nozzles are placed at the same end as the inlet nozzles. To increase the surface area, additional passes can be added or more units can be installed and placed side by side. Air is circulated through the use of multi-blade propeller-type fans that provide either forced or induced drafts. These fans can be equipped with either adjustable speed or variable pitch blades. The pitch of the fan blades can be altered to modify the airflow rate, which in turn compensates for any fluctuations in air temperature, whether it rises or falls. Air coolers are typically installed near the equipment they serve to allow for piping flexibility and easy maintenance. They can be supported at ground level, on top of structures, or above pipe racks. However, the most common installation is above the pipe rack. The tube bundle bank can be supported by steel legs provided by the air cooler vendor or by extending the pipe rack or structure columns to the underside of the bank. Air cooler vendors usually provide header boxes and motor access platforms. Ladders are also included to ensure safe and easy access to the coolers. When designing an air cooler configuration, the plant layout designer needs to consider the source of the supporting column. The animation shows that arrangement A, which is developed by the contractor, allows for changes to the platforming and pipe support loading late in the project without affecting the air cooler vendor scheduled delivery dates to the job site. However, in arrangement B, any such late changes would require the air cooler vendor to redesign the support legs or platform, resulting in delays in delivery and extra costs. Therefore, it is crucial to carefully consider the design of the air cooler configuration to minimize any potential disruptions or delays during the project. Air is not as effective as water for cooling due to its higher ambient temperature and lower heat transfer coefficient. However, using air can save significant costs compared to water cooling, as it requires less containment and infrastructure. Air-cooled heat exchangers are commonly used for condensing petroleum vapors and cooling natural gas to reduce its volume for easy transmission. Most mediums cooled by air-cooled heat exchangers are at low temperatures, and some are also at low pressure. As a result of its low temperature and pressure, an air-cooled heat exchanger presents unique challenges in connecting piping. The primary concern for piping engineers is the allowable forces and moments that an air-cooled heat exchanger can withstand. This table displays the allowable forces and moments for air-cooled heat exchanger nozzles as specified by API Standard 661. It is important to note that these values are not directly related to the actual piping stress, but are instead based on practical and economic considerations of the heat exchanger. The allowable values have a sudden increase for 8-inch nozzles and then remain relatively constant for all larger nozzles. However, meeting these allowable values can be very challenging, particularly for larger nozzle sizes. Special treatments are required to achieve a satisfactory design of the piping system. There are some specific arrangements for the piping used in low-pressure applications. Since the pressure is low, even a slight difference in the inlet or outlet pressure can greatly affect the flow distribution throughout the tube bundles. To ensure an even distribution of flow through all heater sections, a cascading piping layout or a large header construction is required. This guarantees that the inlet and outlet pressures at all tube bundles are the same, which results in the same flow and cooling effect at all bundles. In other words, this type of cascading layout enables all exchanger sections to deliver the full cooling effect. However, achieving the same inlet and outlet pressure at all exchanger sections makes implementing any practical expansion loop very difficult. Any deviation in the piping layout from the ideal configuration will change the inlet and outlet pressure distribution. To avoid the expansion loop, the piping analyst must explore all possible relief scenarios to come up with a good design that can accommodate the allowable nozzle loads. Air-cooled heat exchangers usually have a floating header that can move sideways and lift a bit. This is an important factor to consider when analyzing the piping system, as it affects the piping loads. To get an accurate model of the piping, it is crucial to include the flexibility of both the header and the tube bundle in the analysis. A piping stress engineer should add the air cooler header and bundles into the analysis software by modeling them. The ideal way is to add the air cooler header, tube bundle, inlet piping, and outlet piping into the software. This will give us a more realistic output compared to the individual analysis. While doing this, the weight of the tube bundle, the supporting gaps between the air cooler, and its structure must be modeled suitably. The header can also be modeled as a pipe with a corresponding moment of inertia. You can get more information about industrial equipment's piping design and stress analysis from PipingStress.net. Explore our blogs, engage in hands-on learning, and unlock new possibilities in the world of piping engineering. You can find the link in the description. As we conclude, air-cooled heat exchangers are considered the most efficient cooling solutions available. We have explored their essential components, crucial role, and meticulous design considerations to equip you with the knowledge and confidence to embrace the future of industrial cooling. We appreciate your presence on this enlightening journey and thank you for joining us.